Hi, I'm Clarence Thomas Jr., supervisor at Frank Johnson Recreation Center, and welcome to our outdoor exploration series. During these challenging times when we have COVID-19 chomping on the heels of everybody and confining us to inside so much, it's important that we don't forget about one of the most important aspects of staying healthy, and that's getting outside. The reason that that's important is because outside keeps us centered, it keeps us focused, and it's just plain old good for us. Today we got a beautiful day at our disposal and an awesome outside setting here at Amerson Water Park here in Macon, Georgia. What we're gonna be focusing on in this first series, and it includes all of them, are simple things, simple outside activities that anybody can do at a very nominal cost. I'm a novice at all of these things, and I infuse and incorporate them all into my own lifestyle, but they're working for me, and I'm benefiting greatly from embracing them and partaking of them. Today, we're gonna be focusing on power walking. Power walking is one of those activities that's phenomenal, and it's really good for the body because it gets you moving, but it doesn't afford you or doesn't cost you anything as it relates to overextending yourself or overexerting yourself and running the risk of injuries or something worse, God forbid. We're gonna be focusing on in power walking, number one, of course, the weather, which we have under control. We got a great day to work with. Secondly, we're gonna be focusing on our wear, our gear. It's very important that we dress the part and that we feel the part when we're out power walking. My gear is comprised of, as you can see, sunglasses, which come in handy on the day and cut down on the solar glare for our eyes. A nice hat, I would recommend a nice hat because it also helps create shade around the eyes and around the face, and it reduces the amount of heat that we intake through our skull. The third thing that we're gonna be focusing on, of course, is our preparation, getting ready. That's very, very important. That's the warm-up process, because that's the part that gets our body and especially our muscles and our bones ready to be used during the power walk. Fourth thing that we'll be focusing on, of course, is the cool down and also the recovery. That's very important because that's the period in which we transition away from exerting ourselves and walking fast and doing really hard part and then getting ready to just move on in a way that is healthy and that's safe. All right, so part two, we got a great day to work with, which is part one. Let's go ahead and focus on part two, what we're wearing.
Our shirt should be lightweight, of a cotton or cotton and polyester blend preferably, and very, very body and cool friendly. Our pants should be equally comfortable, consisting of cotton or a cotton and polyester blend as well. And last but certainly not least, our shoes need to be comfortable and they need to be walk friendly, meaning that they need to have a good sole and a good insert to ensure that we don't injure our feet or tire our feet out.
All right, so we got a great day to work with outside. That's number one. Secondly, we look the part and we feel the part. We got our gear working. Now, we gotta get warmed up and get our body ready to be exerted. The first thing we wanna focus on is the stretching. All right, so we're gonna try a simple touch our toes exercise first. But if you can't, just go down as far as you can. And it simply goes like so. And hold for maybe 5 to 10 seconds. When we're done with that one, we're gonna move into this position because we wanna stretch this inner thigh right here. Go one way, this way, 5 or 10 seconds. Then we're gonna come back this way for 5 or 10 seconds. And then we're gonna come back to the position and slowly walk both of them in.
Another good one is stretching out the back thighs. What we want to do here is change our positions at least once to make sure we got both sides covered. If you notice, we're also trying to ensure that we stretch those calf muscles out at the same time. So let's place our hands on our front knee and get a good stretch going. All right, now we're gonna switch over and do the same thing on the other side. Hands on the front knee, stretch those calf muscles out, and keep your balance too.
Then we're gonna come back to the middle, and if you have something to hold on to, what we wanna do in this case is we wanna stretch this part of our thigh, and the best way to do that would be to hold on to something, grab right here, and then stretch slightly till you feel a little bit of a burn. Switch it out, and then we're gonna go here, hold here, and stretch. And now we're ready to power walk. All right, now that we're warmed up and ready to go for our power walk, let's focus a little bit on the form. This is important because power walking is sort of in between running and walking. And as a result, the form helps you to capitalize on it and to take advantage of it. So when we're starting out, we want to just be relaxed, like a normal walk. But then we're gonna add a little bit to it, okay?
There are two techniques that we can use now to propel us forward during the power walk. We can go open hand, swinging our arms back and forth, or we can go closed fist, keeping our elbows above our waist, and then going back and forth to use that as propulsion. Either one of these techniques work very well during the power walk. Now it's time to put all of that together, hit the trail, and power walk.
And that's power walking, folks. It's fun, it's easy, it's safe, and it costs minimal to nothing. I do it all the time, at least once a week, to stay fit and to stay in tune with nature and the outside. The best part of power walking. I'm Clarence Thomas Jr. for Frank Johnson Recreation Center, and this was Outdoor Exploration.